Hello everyone, this is Ashwin again. How is it going? Welcome back to my series of tutorials on OpenCV3 and Python. So in the last video tutorial, we saw how to use webcam with OpenCV3 and Python 3 in order to capture a still image and then how to display that still image on the screen of your computer using matplotlib. So let us execute the same code again in order to have a small revision because we are going to require that code again. So this is me. As I have said earlier, my face is not much photogenic as of now. I am working on that. And in this video tutorial, we are going to see how to use this webcam in order to capture the live video feed. Okay, so let's start modifying the program as per our requirements. So we are going to use the same program for this. We just have to add like a couple of new things, and we just need to delete a couple of old things. So we are not going to use matplotlib because matplotlib is not like very much suitable for showing the live videos, or I don't know actually how to use matplotlib basically to show the live videos. So the earlier part is going to be the same. We are going to create a create an object for video camera, and then we are just going to check whether it opens successfully. I mean, if Python is able to connect to that webcam successfully, and if it opens. Okay, now if this part is success, then we just need to actually add a couple of lines first. Okay, so for window to see the preview of whatever we are doing, we are just going to create a named window, and the window name is going to be the preview literally, or we can just say live video feed, live video feed. Okay, so this is the live video feed window, and now we are going to delete the unnecessary part first. Okay so we have just created a window, and then we have created an object for webcam. We are checking webcam is okay or not, and then what else, we are releasing the camera. So I mean, once the entire program is done, now this part will contain the code to repeatedly show repeatedly read from the video camera, and then display it on the screen. Okay, so that logic is here. Okay, it's like it is only like 5 to 6 lines of logic, but this is going to be very important because we are going to use this thing frequently. Okay, so this skeleton of code, okay, that we are seeing here is going to be used very frequently throughout this series of tutorials. Okay, so now we are creating a loop of using using like RET, the variable and RET as a condition to break the loop. So as we all know that if as long as the cap.read captures an image, RET is true. Okay, so we are just going to keep on checking whether RET is true, and then we are going to read the frame from the camera. Okay, in the shortest time span possible. Okay, for our setup, and then we are going to show it successively with using cv2.imshow function. Okay, with the window name live video feed. So this is a very, very simple program. This is a very basic program, and then every time we are capturing an image, we are just checking if escape key has been pressed, and if the escape key has been pressed, then we are breaking the entire flow. And once the entire flow is broken, we are just destroying the window with the name live video feed, and then we are releasing the camera. So this is the simple function. So I mean, this is the very simple program, and these 5 or 6 lines of code are repetitively going to be used throughout this series of tutorial, because this is actually basically the skeleton of the code which processes the live video. And I'm also going to tell you how to process the live video. Okay, a very simple example. We haven't actually really gotten started yet with the video image processing and the video processing, but still, just to have a gist of like how the real-time video processing, or how the real-time how video processing works on the live feed, I'm going to show you how to convert an image from color image, color video feed to a grayscale video feed live. Okay, so first let's see how a color video feed looks like. So we are just going to execute this program. I don't think that there are any errors in this program, otherwise I would have known. When the video is captured using the webcam, the indicator LED on the webcam is turned on. Okay, so now this is the window. That is me. As I have already told you, my face is not much photogenic. So once we hit the escape key, the entire flow is going to be broken. Okay, so this is how we simply display capture a color image in live, and we just display it. And because we know that persistence of vision phenomena, when you capture and display, or when you display images without any sort of delay, or whenever there is sufficient frame rate, then it becomes a live video, right? So I guess we can perceive motion in like what, 20 fps, 24 fps, right? That I guess for digital films, I mean older film cameras, 24 frames per second was the standard. Nowadays it's like 29.97, that is like approximately 30 frames per second is the standard. So here I don't know like actually how to calculate the frame rate, but if any one of you knows like how to calculate and show the frame rate, you can just like let me know in the comment section down below. Okay, so this is like a very simple thing which displays the color live video. Okay, now we are talking about like video processing, right? So this is the way we process the video. Okay, so output is a variable where which can be used for showing the converting the images from color to grayscale, and we can just like show live output window. So now let's execute this code again. Okay, now this is the same video in the grayscale mode, and let's press the escape key, or let's click this. Okay, let's press the escape key. So the other we can even like have multiple windows of this, like this. We will just say a frame in this. And all windows, we will just make, I'm just like making some modifications so that we should be able to see the grayscale as well as okay, I guess it has been reversed. Output and frame. Okay, so we are like displaying the grayscale as well as the color live videos at the same time. So let's see if there is any problem with this program. Yeah, it works pretty well actually. Okay, so as you can see, you can like see two windows. This window, right? This window is like a live window as it is, and this one is the gray, the window which reads a gray. It is like the processing of the live videos, correct? And that's how we pretty much work with the video processing. So we have just gotten started with video processing and the live video as well as video processing. Okay, with OpenCV3 and Python 3. So I think that this tutorial was like pretty much interesting tutorial, and you learned a lot using this tutorial. Just let me know if you can find a way we can like display FPS, right, frames per second, in the video itself. It will be great. So let me know in the comment section down below. Thanks a lot for watching my video. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I will see you next time.